गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द एक्सरसाइज 5.1 एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 17. द क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 इज फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ए एंड बी सो दैट द फंक्शन एफ डिफाइंड बाय ax plus 1 when x is less than or equal to 3 and bx plus 3 when x is greater than 3 is continuous at x is equal to 3. Means this function is continuous at x is equal to x is equal to 3. So we have to find the relationship between a and b. So let's start. As function is continuous at x is equal to 3, so limit x tends to 3 minus fx is equal to limit x tends to 3 plus fx is equal to f of 3. This is your left hand limit, this is your right hand limit, and this is your function at x is equal to 3. So we have to find all parts one by one separately. So let's first we have to find left hand limit. The left hand limit is limit x tends to 3 minus fx is equal to limit x tends to 3. 3 minus indicate that the value of x is less than 3. When the value of x is less than 3, so the function will be ax plus 1. Ax plus 1. Since ax plus 1 is a polynomial function, so we can take limit directly. On taking limit, this will be equal to 3a plus 1. Next, I am going to find the right hand limit. Your right hand limit is limit x tending to 3 plus fx is equal to limit x tending to 3, and 3 plus indicate that the value of x is greater than 3. When the value of x is greater than 3, your function will be bx plus 3. Again, bx plus 3 is a polynomial function, so we can take limit directly. This will be 3b plus 3. And number third, f of 3. Since f of x at x is equal to 3, the function will be ax plus 1. So this will be 3a plus 1. So you can see here your left hand limit and the function at x is equal to 3 are equal, and limit x tends to 3 plus fx, the value is 3b plus 3, is different from the left hand limit and the function at x is equal to 3. Since this function is continuous at x is equal to 3, so we can find the relationship between a and b directly. So this will be equal to 3a plus 1, or you can write like this. Since function is continuous at x is equal to 3, so your left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. Your left hand limit is 3a plus 1, 3a your left hand limit is 3a plus 1 and your right hand limit is 3b plus 3. 3b plus 3. On solving this equation, a is equal to 3b plus 2, or a is equal to 3b plus 2 upon 3, or a is equal to 3b by 3 plus 2 by 3. 3 and 3 cancel out, or a is equal to b plus 2 by 3. This is your relationship between A and B. So your next question is question number 18, and question number 18 is just like the question number 17, but here in the question number 18 we have to check from the two different point at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. So let's see the question number 18. For what value of lambda? For what value of lambda? The function defined by fx is equal to lambda times x square minus 2x. If x is less than or equal to 0 and function is defined for x plus 1 when x is greater than 0. Continuous at x is equal to 0. And the second question is, what about continuity at x is equal to 1? First, we have to check that for what value of lambda the given function is continuous at x is equal to 0. So let's check one by one. As function is continuous at x is equal to 0, then limit x tending to 0 minus fx is equal to limit x tending to 0 plus fx is equal to f of 0. Limit x tending to 0 minus 0 minus alerts that the value of x is less than 0. When the value of x is less than 0, your function will be lambda times x square minus 2x is equal to limit x tends to 0 plus 0 plus is the sign alerts that the the value of x is greater than 0. So your function will be 4x plus 1, and f of 0 means the value of x is equal to 0. Your function will be lambda times x square minus 2x. On taking limit, lambda times, put the value of x is equal to 0, lambda times 0 square minus 2 into 0 is equal to, on taking limit, 4 into 0 plus 1. Again on taking limit, lambda times 0 square minus 2 into 0. On solving, this will be equal to 0, and this will be equal to 1, and this will be equal to 0, which is not possible, which is not possible. Therefore there is no value, there is no value of lambda for which function is continuous, function is continuous at x is equal to 0. And the second question is, what about continuity at x is equal to 1? So as function is continuous, the number second is, as function is continuous at x is equal to 1. So in this case, here the limit or the equality is given in terms of 0. So in this case, we have to take no need to take left hand limit and right hand limit separately. You can write like this: limit x tends to 1 fx is equal to f of 1. And you can see that here, this is your number line, minus infinity, and this is your plus infinity, and the repeating number is 0. Mark it here. Here we have to find the continuity at x is equal to 1. So the value 1 is lie between 0 and infinity, 0 and plus infinity. So the value of x is always greater than or equal to 1. So when the value of x is greater than or equal to 1, so we will take the function 4x plus 1 in the both case. So limit x tends to 1, 4x plus 1 is equal to, and the function at x is equal to 1, we will take again function 4x plus 1. On taking limit, 4 into 1 plus 1 is equal to 4 into 1 plus 1. On solving this, 4 into 1 plus 1 is 5, is equal to 5. So here the left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to function at x is equal to 1 or equal. Therefore for any value of lambda, function is continuous, function is continuous at x is equal to 1, function is continuous at x is equal to 1. So the next question is question number 19. The question number 19, so that the function defined by gx is equal to x minus greatest integer of x is discontinuous at all integral point. Here this big bracket x means gif of x denotes the greatest integer less than or equal to x, less than or equal to x. And we have already studied about GIF in the first chapter, relation and function. If you have not seen, then you can go and see all the top parts of the relation and function. So let's start. The given function is gx is equal to x minus gif of x. So here in this case g is defined, as you know that g is defined at all integral points, at all integral points, let n be an integer, n be an integer. So let's see, first the function at x is equal to n, so gn will be, or you can write like this, continuity continuity of g at x is equal to n, x is equal to n, gn is equal to n minus gif of n, and this will be equal to n minus, and the gif of n will be n, this will be equal to 0. Next, taking left hand limit, left hand limit, and check the continuity of g at x is equal to n. In the left hand limit, check the continuity of g at x is equal to n. Limit, the left hand limit is denoted by limit x tends to n minus fx, sorry, n minus gx, n minus gx is equal to limit x tends to n, and minus here your left hand and right hand both are same, so the function will be x minus gif of x on taking limit, or you can separate both the parts like this, limit x tends to or put the sign n minus here, put the sign n minus here, and take the both part as separate, limit x tends to n minus x minus limit x tends to n minus gi of x. Now on taking limit, the limit x tends to n minus x will be n minus, and the limit x tends to n minus gif of x will be n minus 1, because the gif of x denotes the greatest integer less than or equal to x. So less than, this will this value is less than or equal to n, and this will be equal to n minus n plus 1, this will be cancelled out, is equal to 1. So you can see here the value of g at x is equal to n is 0, the value of g again at x is equal to n minus is 1. Now I am going to find the right hand limit, continuity at x is equal to n, this is your continuity at x is equal to n minus, and here continuity at x is equal to n plus, this is your right hand limit. So limit x tending to n plus fx will be equal to limit x tending to n plus x minus gif of x, separate both the part, limit x tending to n plus x minus limit x tending to n plus gif of x. On taking limit, the limit x tending to n plus x is n minus, and limit x tending to n plus gif of x will be equal to n. and this will be equal to 0. You can see that your left hand limit, the value of left hand limit is equal to 1. The value of right hand limit is 0, and the function at x is equal to 0, sorry, at x is equal to n is again 0. So the conclusion is your left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. So the function is discontinuous at all integral points. Function is discontinuous at all integral points. Now see the next question, and I am going to solve the question number 20, and you will solve question number 21, and all the questions from 21 you will solve, and 22 is the same as 20 question number 20. So let's see question number 20. The question number 20 is the function defined by fx is equal to x square minus sin x plus 5 continuous at x is equal to pi. We have to check given function is continuous at x is equal to pi. So the given function is fx is equal to x square minus sin x plus 5, and you know that the function is defined at x is equal to pi. The function is defined at x is equal to pi. If the function is defined from x is equal to pi, so consider the limit or consider as function is continuous at x is equal to pi. So here your left hand and right hand both are equal, so we will don't take to separate left hand and right hand. Limit x tends to pi fx is equal to f of pi. Limit x tends to pi fx is equal to f of pi. Limit x tends to pi, the function is x square minus sin x plus 5 is equal to x square minus sin x plus 5. So the solution of this part is not difficult, and the problem is how will I solve this limit. So first I am going to solve this part. So function at x is equal to pi, this will be equal to pi square minus sine pi plus 5, and you know that the value of sine pi is a 0. This will be equal to pi square minus 0 plus 5, and this will be equal to pi square plus 5 is equal to this value, means limit x tending to pi x square minus, or you can solve separate one by one. Now I am going to solve this part, so this will solve as another method. As x tending to pi, then transfer pi into left side, then x minus pi is equal to a new variable h, or x is equal to pi plus h. When the function is in terms of h, then limit should be in terms of h. Again, as x tending to pi, then put the value of x in this equation, then pi is equal to pi plus h, pi and pi cancel, as h tending to 0. So your limit is equal to limit h tending to 0, and here you will replace x by x plus h. X plus h whole square minus sine x plus h plus pi. Separate all the parts as limit h tending to 0, limit h tending to 0, x plus h whole square, sorry, this will be equal to the value of x is pi plus h whole square, and this will also pi plus h, then this will also pi plus h, minus limit h tending to 0 sine pi plus h, and plus limit h tending to 0 pi. On taking limit separately one by one, first taking limit on this side, 0 plus h whole square minus, and in this case you will solve limit h tending to 0 sine a plus b is equal to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b, means sine pi cos h plus cos pi sine h, and the limit h tending to 0 5 is equal to 5 plus 5. So this is your separate limit. Again, separate all the parts, 0 plus h whole square, sorry, again here is a mistake, pi plus 0 whole square. Solve this part, pi square minus limit h tending to 0 sine pi cos h plus limit h tending to 0 cos pi sin h plus 5. This will be equal to pi square minus sin pi cos 0. On taking limit in both part, this part and this part, sin pi cos 0 minus cos pi sin 0 plus 5. On solving, pi square minus the value of sin pi is 0 into, and cos 0 is equal to 1, minus the value of cos pi is minus 1, and the value of sin 0 is 0 plus 5. This will be equal to pi square, this will is 0, and this will be also 0, pi square plus 5. here limit x tending to 5 fx is equal to f of 5, because the limit x tends to 5 fx, the value of limit x tends to 5 fx is equal to pi square plus 5, and the function at x is equal to 5 pi. Limit x tends to pi, the value of limit x tends to pi fx is equal to pi square plus 5, and the function at x is equal to pi is again here pi square plus 5. So the conclusion is, therefore the function is continuous at x is equal to pi. The function is continuous at x is equal to pi. Now students, you will try to solve question number 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.